Hi there, I'm Brooke Baldwin. You're watching CNN. It is Friday. Thanks for being here. No time to waste for these presidential candidates with the debates behind them. The only face-off now, the finish line, November 8th, Election Day. Just 2 weeks and 4 days away, the Trump and the Clinton campaigns, they are blitzing these battleground states to get out the vote. You see the surrogates are in those key states, Pennsylvania, Florida, New Hampshire, and in just a little bit, we'll see Hillary Clinton in Ohio. Now, Donald Trump spoke just a little while ago in North Carolina. He did not mention the wave of polls showing his campaign losing ground, but Trump did mention the possibility of losing on November 8th.
I will be happy with myself because I always say, I don't want to think back, if only I did one more rally, I would have won North Carolina by 500 votes instead of losing it by 200 votes, right? What a waste of time if we don't pull this off. You know, these guys have said, doesn't matter if you win or lose. There's never been a movement like this in the history of this country. I say it matters to me whether we win or lose. So I'll have over $100 million of my own money in this campaign.
And as the campaign's focus on the top of the ballot, Trump's fellow Republicans are now trying to figure out what to do with the races that follow. We'll call it the down-ballot dilemma. How do they save the Republican majorities in both the House and the Senate in the midst of sort of Trump's turmoil? Let me go straight to Dana Bash, our CNN chief political correspondent. 18 days, not that anyone is counting. what can the party do at this point?
Well, the message all along, and more importantly, the money all along that has been going from conservative groups that aren't really enamored with Trump, the money and the message has been all focused on keeping a majority in Congress, most importantly, the Senate, because that's the one that is in the most question as far as Republicans go. The big change as of this morning is a new group, the Chamber of Commerce, which is a traditionally GOP group, part of the establishment wing of the party, has a new ad on television in New Hampshire, not just focusing on the Senate incumbent Republican, Kelly Ayotte, but the message specifically is to voters, hey guys, it's pretty likely that Hillary Clinton is going to be in the White House. You got to elect Kelly Ayotte as a check and balance. Let's watch part of the ad.
Sure.
America's future is far from certain, but no matter who the next president is, New Hampshire needs a strong voice in the U.S. Senate. That Senator, Kelly Ayotte. She works across the aisle to get things done. Maggie Hassan's record? Hassan voted over 100 times for more taxes and fees. Just imagine what she'd do unchecked in Washington with a new president.
Now, let me just show you, just still focused on New Hampshire, where things stand right now in terms of public polling. A WMUR poll came out yesterday showing Maggie Hassan, the state's governor, and the Democratic challenger at 46%, Kelly Ayotte at 38%, an 8-point deficit for the incumbent Republican. That is why the Chamber of Commerce decided to start there, because they think that is the most dire. It's also a presidential battleground state where Donald Trump has been many times, and he has even a bigger deficit in that same poll, but much bigger. Oh, there you see the presidential poll, but at a much broader level. The hope at the Chamber of Commerce, Brooke, is that other Republican groups, even candidates themselves, see this as a signal it is time to really pull the plug on any notion that Donald Trump is going to win the White House, and make it very clear to voters who historically have been okay with even liking divided government as a check and balance notion. Now, Democrats who I've gotten emails from say that they don't think that this is a message that really works with voters. You know, who knows? If there's a wave election, they're probably right. But at least at this point, just 18 days left, Republicans feel like they've got to try their best to save who they can. And at this point, it is the Republican majority in the Senate that they're most focused on, even as, I mean, let's just face it, they're throwing Donald Trump all under the bus, or they would say facing reality.
Let's see how our Trump surrogate friend here feels about that. With that note, Dana Bash, thank you so much. Let's expand the conversation.